To score the points you can win for yourself by sharing the ride with others and saving money. Ride sharing is a team effort. Be a part of it the Georgia way.
Ray Moore and Lynn Harrison today on Action News at Noon.
Get ready to match the stars from Mork and Mindy, Robert Donner. Patty Duquesne. Charles Nelson Reilly. Betty Kennedy. McLean Stevenson. And George Dulamont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
I'll take your temperature in a moment, nurse. What can I do for you? Are you all right here?
Everything's fine, thank you.
You changed your hairdo.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. No, it looks okay.
Oh, okay.
It's just startling.
Very beautiful woman.
Yes, she is a beautiful woman, and a gifted one, too. We're all gifted. Thank you. All beautiful and talented, aren't we? Say yes, everybody.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, let's meet our two weirdos over here, Debbie Stolman and Dorothy Knoll. Ladies, just to refresh the memories of our viewers, Debbie, you remember, is this attractive young lady who's a truck driver, drives in the 11 western states. Mm-hmm. And what kind of truck rig do you drive? It's an 18-wheeler?
It's an 18-wheeler, yeah.
All right, Debbie. And Dorothy Knoll here, her husband and her two children are here, right?
Right.
Yeah. Those three handsome people there in the first row.
Mm-hmm.
She's vacationing here from Kansas City, is that right?
No, Hayes, Kansas.
Old Hayes. Kansas.
Hayes, Kansas.
Oh, Hayes, Kansas.
Right.
Just plain Hayes,
just
Kansas.
Just plain Hayes.
Yeah. How many people in Hayes?
18,000.
18,000?
We're a big town.
There were more people on my block in New York than that. Yeah.
We can spread them out in Kansas.
I guess you can. Now, let's see. It's 1-1 here. She went first last time, so that means you go first this time.
No. A.
All right. What do you say for A? Mildred said, "My husband reminds me of Italy. That's because his blank looks like the Leaning Tower of Pisa." Ready, Chuck? Here we go.
All right.
Mildred said, "My husband reminds me of Italy. That's because his blank looks like the Leaning Tower of Pisa."
Nose.
Nose is good. What do you say?
You know, it's amazing when you hear the obvious answer.
Right, nose. Yeah, right.
Nose.
Aha!
Oh, hey.
Good artwork, too.
You really are Robert Donner, are you?
Yes, I am, and I'm available for parties.
No kidding. You do stand-up and all that?
Yes, yeah. Little cartoons.
Yeah.
I'll work beaches if you'll send me.
Okay. I got one beach I'll send you to. Nose! Hey, that's two for Dorothy.
Oh, Charles, I'm sorry.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Wait a minute. Charles
just,
is weeping here.
I'm sorry.
Here.
I tried to pull myself together all day.
Yes.
You're seeing the picture of those makeup people coming off the elevator.
Yeah.
When they were saved.
They were saved.
Some of those people were in the elevator 4 or 5 minutes. And you see them. I just, and if Patty Duke could only act this well, no.
Are you crying? Did he move you to tears?
Oh, what a performance. Yeah.
Right.
How about to your
Broadway? Four noses for Dorothy. Betty, husband reminds me of Italy. His blank looks like the Leaning Tower of Pisa.
Gosh, I hope they leave this on the air because I like it. No, I put nose.
Oh.
Had your word, didn't I?
Yeah.
Had you going.
All right, Joyce.
I wouldn't worry
you.
I said
no. Okay, that all sticks. Now, the best you can do is try. But you can do that if you match all five that you've met. Everyone except Joyce, please. Ed Sullivan said, anybody do Ed Sullivan?
No.
No, nobody does Sullivan. All right. Ed Sullivan said, our next act is Tommy the Tap Dancer. Tommy is unusual because when he tap dances, he wears blank shoes. That's it. All right, Debbie.
I know Tommy.
Ed Sullivan said our next act is Tommy the Tap Dancer. Tommy is unusual because when he tap dances, he wears blank shoes.
Snowshoes.
Snowshoes. That would be difficult. Now, what Debbie is saying is that she expects every one of these dingbats to say snowshoes. An unlikely possibility, I must admit.
Not for us.
But let's begin.
That'd be a nifty act.
Yep.
I said tennis shoes.
Tennis shoes. So that means Dorothy wins her game. Come on down, Dorothy. What the rest of you have? Let's see. Tennis. Tennis. Snow. Open toe wedgies. And that's it. Okay. Now, we're going to wheel you around here on the carousel and bring you back later for game number two. And right now, we're going to see how you do with the big super match here. Good luck to you, my dear. Here we go. This is where you could win over $10,000. We polled a studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Get on your blank. Get on your blank. Three of the six stars can assist. Whom do you want?
McLean.
Horse.
All right, there's one.
Patty.
Get on your marks. All right.
Charles.
Get off your... Oh, no. Get... Are the judges seeing that he's mouthing something to me?
Now, watch it.
Oh. Excellent, Charles. What a wonderful idea you have.
Get on your nerves.
Oh, that's good, Charles.
Oh, yeah.
Very good. You just thought of that, right? Okay. Get on your mark, get on your nerves, and get on your horse. Those are the three. You have an option now. Choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Mark.
Yeah. Mark. That was Patty's answer.
Get
on your mark is what she's after. Let's see if it's under the $100 response. Mark it is, right off the bat. Now, under the next one we have... Get on your feet. That's a good one, isn't it? What do you think's going to be on top?
Horse.
Horse? How come you didn't say it earlier?
Well, it's my second choice.
It was your second choice. Well, it was an honest answer. Let's see if we got horse on top. Yep. All right, now listen, you've got $100.
Hey,
that means you'll play for $1,000.
Where's nerves? All of that.
Yeah.
Where was that? If you're going to give me an answer, give me one that gets on the board. Mr. Marcel Marceau.
Charles, I don't mind hanging with you. You open your mouth one more time. Who's stepping on my mic? Oh, you're stepping on my mic. That's all right. Now listen, you're going to play for $1,000 or $2,000. It all depends on the wheel. Want to go up there?
Double!
Double!
Anarchy! Here we go. $1,000 with Charles Nelson Reilly. Face me if you would please, because you may be a better lip reader than he is. Here it is. Chill blank. Chill blank. Your job is to match Charles, Dorothy. If you do that, you get $1,000. What do you say?
Chili.
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 He was a very famous Western star.
Now, wait a minute. Now, wait. He was a famous actor in the Chinese theater. His name was Chili.
Yeah.
He was wonderful.
He was Canada Lee's
played in all
brother.
The Charlie Chan movies. He was just great. You remember Chill Lee, don't you?
I do.
It is good. Thank you very much,
I
Betty.
Do.
Yes. It's getting a little chilly in here myself.
Yes,
well, if
I,
she...
Right, yes.
I remember.
If she... If she was that close to the man who mimes nerves for the answer, anything is... I said factor. Chill factor.
Chill factor.
Or Mac.
All right. Listen, we'll get Dorothy Knowles' opponent back here in a moment or so, but right now we have this message for America.
Save money on long distance. AT&T says call after 11 p.m. Very smart, AT&T. All I know is if my phone rings after 11, it's either a wrong number or a very cheap friend. So to save money on your out-of-state calls anytime with no restrictions before and after 11, I say switch to MCI. You'll sleep much better. Hello? Heidi! She's so cheap.
Call MCI and then call anywhere AT&T goes across Georgia and across the country.
Oh, this is a Likes Meaty Jumbo. This is a bottomless pit. It eats most things that aren't tied down. That includes hot dogs. That's why I buy this one. It's got 25% less fat. That's more lean meat, and that's better for my whole family. Especially the disposal. Would you like a jar of pickles to go with that?
Likes Meaty Jumbos. Less fat, more lean. Beef jumbos, too.
What's the big difference between my babies? The little one has newborn skin. Mm-hmm. Her daddy's skin's a lot tougher. That's why when we wash baby clothes, instead of adult detergents made with tough cleaning additives, we use Ivory Snow, made from pure baby mild soap, like we bathe her with, for clothes that are gentle on newborn skin. His clothes get detergent.
But baby gets Ivory Snow.
Baby mild Ivory Snow, instead of adult detergent.
He doesn't like the dog he bought.
And I turned around, looked at the dog, and there he was tearing a screen open.
On the People's Court.
That's today at 4.
The Georgia Society to Prevent Blindness offers free information and eye screening to catch eye disorders while there's still time for prevention. Because some people don't see why they should have their eyes checked. And some people don't see. Don't lose sight. Call Prevent Blindness now.
Here we go. Welcome back, Debbie.
Thank you.
She's got $100. Now we go to the second and final game and see how we do with that. You may have A or B.
B, please.
Our lady truck driver says she wants B. Bernie is the world's toughest baseball player. Well, I'll tell you how tough he is. Not only does he chew tobacco, he chews blanks. Okay, Debbie. Bernie is the world's toughest baseball player. Not only does he chew tobacco, he chews blanks.
Baseballs.
All right.
That's a secret.
He must have a big mouth.
Yes. I said bats.
Bats.
Or upside down umbrellas.
All right. No, that's a bat. That's a bat flying around.
Oh, a bat.
Yes.
I get it.
Ah, little play on words there. What do you say?
He won from Exeter. I say umpires.
Umpires. And they loved it.
Whoa.
Bases.
All right, she said baseball.
Big hand.
What do you say, Betty? Not only does he chew tobacco, he chews...
I think I'll leave you in suspense. Bats. Thank you.
Okay, McLean.
pardon me. I said bats.
You said bats.
Yes.
Yeah.
I didn't think you could say the other word.
You could say baseballs.
We thought of only the word I was thinking of.
Oh, I see. All right, Joyce.
Do you?
I said that he chews AstroTurf.
Oh. AstroTurf.
Yes.
Go chew your AstroTurf. All right. We'll go to round two. Since we have a scoreless tie, she went first. What? Bring it back up. I left a... Did I leave one question out? I'm sorry about that.
In the elevator.
Oh, yes, I did. I thought we had done both questions, but we hadn't.
That's
so
right.
Dorothy...
It got locked in the elevator.
Santa Claus said, ho,
Henry
ho,
is the
ho.
Second thing to go. I'm sorry.
Ho, 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 said Santa Claus. You all know I have a list of who's naughty and who's nice. Well, my nice list I made up myself, but I got my list of who's naughty from blank. Is that too long for you, gang? I mean, is that too much for you to retain? Santa Claus said, ho, 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 you all know I have a list of who's naughty and who's nice. Well, my nice list I made up myself, but I got my list of who's naughty from...
Is that J.R. Ewing on Dallas?
J.R. Ewing, the evil man. Right.
Yeah.
J.R. Ewing on Dallas, an evil person. What do you say?
Well, I sure wish I'd said J.R. Ewing. I hope I don't get hurt for this, but I said Jerry Falwell.
Jerry Falwell!
Yeah.
He
knows, you know.
He does.
Yeah.
And he'll tell on you, too, won't he?
He'll
tell. He's a snitcher.
He knows my name.
Right, he does know your name.
Or is that when I'm gone.
Yeah, right. Well, I'm going to hide. I don't want him to find me.
You have had it.
Rona Barrett. There's a good one. Rona Barrett.
Barrett.
Yes, the gossip lady. What do you say to this? I made up the nice list, but I got my list of who's naughty from.
Well, I thought it was Tinkerbell because the way he flies around, you know.
Oh, he knows all the gossip.
Tinkerbell's a girl, you dummy.
Well, see what I mean?
Tinkerbell was her answer.
Wait a minute.
That's a girl.
Wait a minute.
Tinkerbell is not a girl.
Tinkerbell's a fairy.
Tinkerbell has no gender.
That's right. Tinkerbell is a little...
Tinkerbell has neuter gender.
Oh, no. She is referred to as she by Peter.
In Peter Pan? No.
Pray
to Tinkerbell, she'll help you? No.
No.
All right.
Okay.
Whatever. You ready, McLean?
Do you believe in fairies? Everyone who believes in fairies will fly. You won't fly.
Okay, Joyce.
What was the question? Are there fairies?
I made up my license. No. We've disposed of that. We know that that's not true. I made up the nice list myself, but I got my list of who's naughty from.
From who?
Wait a minute.
They know. I gave them the answer.
I don't know.
They saw it. That's all right.
I didn't
see it.
You
had to hold it up.
Did
you see it?
That's all I want to
tell. Did you see it? I didn't see it. Who'd she say? Get out. All right, here we go. Second and last round. Score is still tied, ladies. As I predicted it would be. We could have eliminated that question completely. She went first last time, so you go first this time. A or B? B? B. Oh, A. All right, here we go. Weird Willie got a weird new job. He catches sparrows, dips them in yellow paint, and sells them as blanks.
He catches sparrows?
Yeah.
Again, sparrows?
Yeah.
I didn't hear it.
You were talking. You weren't listening. Dorothy, Weird Willie got a weird new job. He catches sparrows, dips them in yellow paint, and sells them as blanks.
The decorations on the trunk of the hood of the car, the...
The radiator emblem?
No, yeah, whatever that sits on the hood of the car.
The emblem. Hood ornament?
Yeah.
Wonderful answer, Dorothy.
Goodbye,
hello, Robert.
Daddy.
Well, thank heaven Dorothy took the heat off me.
Yes.
I said that he does what? Catches small sparrows.
Dips them in yellow paint.
And sells them as small ducks.
You took the heat off him.
Precious, can I go sit with Dorothy now?
Yes.
Okay.
That's two weird answers so far, hers and his. Go ahead. You sit over there. All the dumb answers are going to sit over there now. What do you got?
Never mind.
All right.
Canaries or dwarf pigs?
No, canaries is all right. Yeah. What do you got?
It happened to my mother once in New Britain, Connecticut, many years ago. She won a canary and got home, and all the yellow powder was at the bottom of the cage.
Oh.
It's true. And that sort of sums up my whole life at home.
Yeah.
Canary.
Cut the yellow canary story.
How was your visit with Dorothy?
Very nice.
He dips them in yellow paint and sells them as...
Canary.
Oh. Canaries never crossed your mind?
Never did, no.
A sparrow painted yellow would look like a canary, wouldn't it?
Yes, close. That's why I put that down.
You put that down. What did you put down?
A fairy.
Really?
You're going to get letters.
All right, Debbie.
Yellow fairy.
Debbie needs one to tie. Listen carefully, everybody. Dumb Dora called the doctor and said, Doc, I think I have colitis. Whenever I walk, my blanks collide. Here we go, Debbie. Dumb Dora called the doctor and said, Doc, I think I have colitis. Whenever I walk, my blanks collide.
Knees?
All right. She played it safe and said knees. What do you say?
What's knees got to do with colitis?
Collide.
Collide?
My blanks collide.
Oh, I thought the word was colitis. Knees.
Ah, that wins the game. What do the rest of you have?
Knees.
Thighs. Boom! Attaboy, Chuck. Come on down, Debbie. Dorothy Knoll has $100. We're going to send her some prizes, too. An ingrown toenail for one. Thank you very much, Dorothy Knoll. Goodbye. Here's a message for you.
We made it big in the 50s.
In rock and roll.
The big things in life
have always been our goal.
So when we want big chicken cooked up just right,
only Church's Big Chicken
satisfies our appetite.
Cause Church's takes a chicken
so much bigger in size,
cuts it into fewer pieces
than those other guys.
So dollar for dollar, we get so much more.
We love Church's Big Chicken.
That's a yakety yak.
Their big juicy chicken, it always brings us back.
Church's, we give you more of a good thing with 3 ears of corn for just 99 cents with any family or super family order.
It's Showtime Cable TV.
Excuse me, how do I...
Today's the day we're gonna make you happy.
Hey, what do I have to...
Showtime's gonna make you realize we make it so...
Wait a minute. All I want to know is how do I get it?
Get what?
Showtime!
Oh, we thought you'd never ask. You just dial this number and ask for Showtime.
That's it? I just dial this number and I can get those Broadway hits, those blockbuster movies, and those original comedies I've heard about?
Uh-huh. And if you subscribe now, you also get a special money-saving offer plus a free colorful tote bag.
You sure I just dial this number?
Yep, then we're all yours.
Look what we got. I feel the hot music and dance. Loud and romance. Great comic bits. Big Broadway hits. Applause, applause. Give Showtime because we make it.
Call now for our money-saving offer and a tote bag, too.
I'm so excited.
We're the American Red Cross, working 24 hours a day to keep service members and their families in touch when it counts the most.
Today at 4:30 on Alice, Tommy drops a bomb.
I've made up my mind. I'm quitting school.
At 5, Klinger gets some bad news of his own.
That's 6 months of hard labor.
I don't like either of those words.
But at 5:30, it's Hawkeye Pierce for the defense.
Only a little ex post facto, habeas corpus, flagrante delicto, delightful and lovely.
It's great entertainment. Starting with a People's Court at 4, Alice at 4:30, and MASH at 5 and 5:30. Today on WSB TV Channel 2.
If you want to see MASH game in person, send a self-addressed stamped envelope to Tickets. MASH game, CBS Television City. 7800 Beverly Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90036. As a member of the studio audience, you may win the Dreammaker from Bassett. Give just the right combination of firm support and soothing softness. Dreammaker from Bassett. And our contestants will receive a pair of beautiful digital watches for a man and woman. Timex, we're making time look good. And from Kinney, a great selection of great American shoe styles. Kinney's got the look you want, America. That's why Kinney is a great American shoe store. And Baker's Secret from Echo, the silicone-coated nonstick bakeware, is the easy way to better baking, makes cleanup easy as pie. Here again is the star of our show, Gene Rayburn.
All right. Thank you, John. Here we go with Debbie Stillman. She could go for the big ball of wax here and see how it goes. Good luck to you, my dear. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank gloss. Three of the six stars. Betty seems to have an answer. You want to call on her?
Betty. Lip gloss.
That's one.
Charles.
That wax on the floor? No.
Yeah.
What's it called? High gloss.
High gloss,
which won the third race at Pimbrino in Long Park. High gloss.
One more.
Robert.
Rocky Gloss.
Oh, he was a great fighter.
Hell of a fighter.
Ah.
Great fighter.
That was undefeated.
Undefeated.
Okay. Rocky Gloss. Don't dump Rocky, I'm telling you.
High gloss and lip gloss. Rocky gloss. You want one of those or one of your own?
Lip gloss.
Lip gloss is what you want. Let's find out if it's up there and if so, where. Let's go down to the bottom, reveal a $100 response. Semi-gloss.
Oh, that was,
that's okay.
That was
Rocky
the next
fought
one
him.
Says high gloss. Gloss. Now, she's looking for lip gloss. Let's see if it's right here.
Yeah!
Yes, it is. Very good. Very good. Oh, well. Now you got $500. The least you'll play for is $5,000. But we want you to get up here and spin the wheel, see if you can double it up and play for $10,000. Good luck. Here we go.
Black.
Robert Donner. Here we go. Good luck to you right on the blue dot facing me. This is it. It says, fuzz blank. That's F-U-Z-Z blank. No help from the audience, please. Fuzz blank. She's ready anytime you're ready, Robert.
Not easy.
Yes, all right, your job is to match him. If you do, you get $5,000.
Fuzzball?
Fuzzball.
Yeah! That's it.
You're a trucker. Haven't you ever heard of Fuzzbuster, right?
Fuzzbuster, that's right.
I'm sorry, I said that.
$500 for that little lady, Debbie Stolman, and now this message for America.
Blue Plate introduces new Blue Plate light mayonnaise. Creamy, delicious with all the taste but half the calories. And that's what makes it so incredibly light.
Home accents from Belk. Dazzling value for your home during the summer white sale. Now. Presenting our exclusive State Pride decorators by Springmade. Vibrant fashion colors completely coordinated. Dependable solids, snappy stripes, and breezy florals. Decorators by Springmade at special white sale prices. Add your home accents. The summer white sale now at Belk.
Of the leading monthly relief products, you know how many are formulated to relieve the three problems so many of us have? Only one. Pamprin. In fact, a panel of medical experts appointed by the Food and Drug Administration found the ingredients in Pamprin safe and effective for cramps, temporary water gain, and simple monthly tension. So, for relief from all three, take this. Pamprin.
Real relief from cramps, water gain, and simple monthly tension. Pamprin.
The Georgia Society to Prevent Blindness offers free information and eye screening to catch eye disorders while there's still time for prevention. Because some people don't see why they should have their eyes checked. And some people don't see. Don't lose sight. Call Prevent Blindness now.
They're playing a deadly game. Nazi versus British. Spy versus spy. A chilling combination. Where even the bedroom becomes a battlefield.
I have told you I'm not a prostitute.
The chilling conclusion of this movie premiere.
I am not dangerous.
Oh, yes, you are.
The Key to Rebecca, starring Cliff Robertson, David Soul. Season Hubley, tonight at 9, here on WSB TV, Channel 2.
Hey, Hope Pete, Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time for the Match Game. Thank you all. Goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive a cookbook and Uncle Van. It takes the time to make rice right. Uncle Van's long grain of wild rice has combined two quality rices and 23 seasonings to make it any meal special. A cheese server and Gino's Party Special Pizza with a crisp and tasty crust you can trust, plus the flavor shaker. Gino's in your grocery freezer. The Metz Turtles, delicious pecan wrapped in caramel, covered with smooth, delicious chocolate. Look for the Metz Turtles in fine stores everywhere. And a hairdryer and Jerry Redding Milk and Honey Salon at Home. Complete hair care styling system. Jerry Redding, a favorite of professional hairdressers for 20 years. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. The program is edited for broadcast.
That was a nice save the other day, Gossett.
Remind me.
The jumper on the dam.
Karen.
Karen. She must have left quite an impression.
You know, I don't think she actually wanted to jump.
Why do you say that?
The way she reacted when I found her. She was disoriented, confused. Said she didn't know how she got there.
Yeah, they just found a body in her shed. I don't think she was exactly, you know, in a healthy frame of mind.
On nine in the afternoon.
Do you know where her husband is, right?
No.
Otto Croft. the psychotherapist. I know, right? Imagine what he's going through right now.
No, I don't believe it.
What?
That she killed anyone.
On my internet archive?
Is that what you told the police?
Well, they didn't ask for my opinion.
It's just the facts. You're such a Boy Scout.
Match game. Every day.
What do I do?
The match game, weekdays at 5.
For laughs and cash prizes, watch Match Game with Jean Rayburn.
Your job is to match her. How do you fill in that blank?
Bread.
Day old bread. All right, Betty, she says day old bread will match her for the $5,000. What do you say to that?
There were two day old cakes, but I didn't say anything. Day old bread.
Day old bread.
Big cash prizes every weekday morning at 11 on Match Game here on Channel 6.
Buzzer celebrates National Spelling Bee Week with Match Game Misspellings.
I said it's a hamster.
A hamster. In our own Buzzer Bee. The Match Game second annual Buzzer Bee starts May 27th, only on Buzzer. Let's spell.